गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, वेलकम अगेन ऑन माय यूट्यूब चैनल। एज यू ऑल नो, नाउ इट इज वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट चैप्टर फर्स्ट साइंस क्लास 7, दैट इज न्यूट्रिशन इन प्लांट्स, राइट। इन प्रीवियस वीडियोस वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द डिफरेंट टॉपिक्स लाइक न्यूट्रिशन, न्यूट्रिएंट्स, फोटोसिंथेसिस, ऑटोट्रॉपिक मोड ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन, स्टोमेटास एंड ऑल दैट। ओके, सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द हेटरोट्रॉपिक मोड ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन। सो व्हाट इज बेसिकली हेटरोट्रॉपिक न्यूट्रिशन? द डेफिनेशन इज ऑर्गेनिजम्स विच आर नॉट एबल to make their own food and depends on other green plants or living organisms repeating the definition, organisms which are not able to make their own food just because of presence of chlorophyll. So they will depend on other green plants as well as on other living organisms are called heterotrophs. Heterotrophic nutrition is of four types. Now what are those types? Let's discuss one by one. So these are the four types of heterotrophic nutrition. First one is parasitic nutrition. Second one is saprophytic nutrition. Third one is symbiotic nutrition. Is insectivorous plants. So these are the four categories of heterotrophic nutrition: parasitic nutrition, saprophytic nutrition, symbiotic nutrition, and insectivorous plants. Let's discuss them one by one. So firstly, we will discuss about the parasitic nutrition. Organisms which are not able to make their own food and depends upon other green plants or living organisms are called parasites. I'm repeating the definition: organisms which are not able to make their own food and depend upon other green plants or other living organisms are called parasites. Now the examples of parasitic nutrition is, first one is Cestuda, and Kashmir are generally called Amar Bel. I think you all have heard about it. And second one is the plant Rafflesia. So these are the examples. Now we will discuss Cuscuta plant with a diagrammatic presentation. Basically, parasites live inside or upon another green plant that is known as host, and this host will provide nutrition and food to the Cuscuta plant. So here is a host plant. As you can see, this one is host plant and this one is Cuscuta, that is Amar Bel. Now this Amar Bel or Cuscuta will survive upon this host plant. This host plant is having chlorophyll and do the process of photosynthesis. So it will prepare the food, right? And the food which is prepared by the host plant will consumed by the Cuscuta Amar Bel. Okay? Now the second type of heterotrophic mode of nutrition is saprophytic nutrition. Now, what is the definition of saprophytic nutrition? Organisms which obtain food and nutrients from other, from dead and decaying organic matter. The definition: organisms that obtain nutrients and food from dead and decaying organic matter are called saprophytes. Basically, these saprophytes secrete some digestive juices, some digestive enzymes. Now these are digested by the dead plant and then convert into some soluble end products. Now these soluble end products are consumed by the saprophytes, and in this way they will do the heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Now the examples of saprophytic nutrition are, first one is mushroom. I think you all are aware about mushrooms. And second one is bread mold, right? Now look over the diagram of mushroom. This umbrella like structure is known as mushrooms, and this one is dead plant. As I have told you, they will secrete some digestive enzymes. They will digest it and convert some soluble end products. Now these nutrients, these soluble end products are consumed by our mushrooms. These are mushrooms. This one is dead plants. And these are the nutrients which are absorbed by the saprophyte, that is mushroom. So in this diagram you can see these are the mushrooms and this is a dead plant, right? Now the mushrooms will secrete some digestive juices. Now these digestive juices are digested by the dead plants and they will convert it into soluble end products. Now these soluble end products are consumed by the mushrooms. So this is the mode of nutrition in mushroom, that is saprophytic nutrition, right? Now let's come the third category of heterotrophic nutrition, that is symbiotic nutrition. Firstly, we will discuss the definition. Organisms which live together like friends and share food, nutrients and shelter. This is known as symbiosis. So basically, in symbiotic nutrition, two organisms give benefits to each other, right? First example of symbiotic nutrition is leguminous plants. Now what are leguminous plants? The plants which are having pulses like pea, mung, beans, etc. etc. And the second example of symbiotic nutrition is lichen. Right? Now we will discuss the diagram of leguminous plants. In leguminous plants, there are certain bacteria which are found in the root nodules of the plants, and this bacteria and plants which will give benefit to each other. These are the roots in which nodules are found, and in these nodules Rhizobium leguminosarum bacteria is found. This one is leguminous plant. These are the root nodules, and in these nodules the bacteria is found which is known as Rhizobium leguminosarum. Now the question is how the bacteria and the plants will give benefit to each other. As you all know, leguminous plants are having chlorophyll, so they can make their own food by the process of photosynthesis. Now the bacteria which is present in the nodules of leguminous plants will take nitrogen from the atmosphere and convert it into soluble form, that is nitrate, as nitrogen is not directly absorbed by the plants. They need to convert it firstly in the nitrate form. So this work is done by the bacteria, that is Rhizobium. Basically Rhizobium takes nitrogen from the atmosphere and convert into soluble form, that is nitrate. Now, with the help of these nitrate, the plants are able to make protein and insect, right? So, and in return, the plant will provide food and nutrient to the bacteria rhizobium. So, in this way, both the plant and the bacteria will give benefit to each other. So, this mode of nutrition is known as symbiosis. Now, we are coming to the last category of heterotrophic nutrition, that is known as insectivorous plants. And these are really interesting. Now, what are insectivorous plants? The plants which trap and eat insects to absorb nitrogenous products from the insects are called insectivorous plants. Here is the definition. I am repeating again. The plants which trap and eat insects to absorb nitrogenous product from the insects are called insectivorous plants. Basically, these plants are found in nitrogen deficient soil, right? So, they are not able to absorb the nitrogenous product. So, the question is why, how they will able to absorb the nitrogenous products. Now, so for this purpose, these plants will trap, they will attract insects, they will trap insects and finally they will digest them, eat them. Now, with the help of these insects, they will absorb the nitrogenous product, right? Now, the examples of insectivorous plants are the pitcher plant, second one is Venus flytrap, now we will discuss the structure of insectivorous plant, that is pitcher plant, and it is really having an interesting structure. Let's have a look on the diagram. These are having a pitcher-like structure which arises from the leaves, as it is known as the pitcher plant. So these are having pitcher-like structure. These are the pitchers. This is the leaf of the pitcher plant. This is known as petiole. This one is feature, as you can recognize it by your sight. This is the lid of the pitcher. This one is peristome. And inside the pitcher, this found digestive zone. So this is the complete structure of pitcher plant. Let's have a look over the diagram. These are the leaves. This is known as petiole. This one is pitcher. This complete structure is known as pitcher. And there are three parts of the pitcher. First one is lid. Second one is the digestive zone. And third one is peristome. Right? Now, what are their functioning? How they will work? Let me tell you, these pitchers are colorful and attractive, right? And they will attract the insects. Now the insects will attract towards these colorful pitchers. As soon as the insect will attract towards these pitchers, now the lid will get open. The lid of the pitcher will get open and the insects will come inside the pitcher. As the insect will enter inside the pitcher, the lid of the pitcher will get closed. Now, the insect which is inside the pitcher is digested by the plant. And finally, they get nitrogenous product from the insects. As the insect will get digested, again, the lid of the pitcher will get open to attract one more insect. Now this process is going on. Insects will get attracted towards the pitcher and then finally they will trap by the pitcher and the lid of the pitcher will get closed and finally again the insect will get digested by the pitcher. And in this way they get the nitrogenous product from the insects, right? So it's all about insectivorous plants which absorb nitrogenous products from the insects as they are found in the nitrogenous deficient soil. So here we have discussed all the four types of heterotrophic nutrition, that is parasitic nutrition, saprophytic nutrition, symbiotic nutrition and insectivorous plants. So here is the ending of the chapter. Now the chapter has been over, right? So tomorrow we will discuss another chapter. Till then, goodbye students. Have a nice day.